Yatala viewers, thank you for joining us. You want to set up a business, but you have no funds. Today for this new edition, we are going to receive Mr. Paul Mbua, a funds manager, an entrepreneur who has the solution. How? Let's find out in Believe in Africa.
Félicitations! Vous gagnez 1000 francs de crédit gratuit pour votre premier dépôt du mois.
Yellow, oui c'est bon, à toi de jouer.
Yellow, à toi de jouer.
Parce qu'on sait que tes rêves ne veulent plus attendre.
Yellow, à toi de jouer.
Avec déjà plus de 30 000 points de retrait et des milliers de points de paiement à travers le pays, MTN Momo est le réseau le plus étendu pour être encore plus proche de toi. Et en cadeau, en ce moment, nous t'offrons 1000 francs de crédit de communication gratuit à chaque premier dépôt du mois. Maintenant, à toi de jouer.
Mr. Paul Mbua is here with us today. Mm-hmm. Welcome.
Thank you very much. Thank you for inviting me. And I'm happy to be here.
What does it mean, Mbua?
Mbua means rain. When it pours, when it rains, that's the meaning of my name. So I come with a lot of blessing.
Oh my goodness. Yes. Can you please introduce yourself to the televiewers?
Yes, my name is Paul Mbua. I'm a Cameroonian, but I'm a citizen of the world. And also I'm an entrepreneur. Basically, what I do is come up with ideas and see how to solve the problems within my community and in Africa in particular. And I'm an ecosystem architect, which simply means that we build and we raise lots of entrepreneurs.
What about your academic background?
Okay, for my academic background, I studied IT. And after my certification with ASAF,
are you a product made in Cameroon?
I'm a product practically made in Cameroon, built in Cameroon. Yes.
Okay. You are a funds manager, mm-hmm. entrepreneur, mm-hmm. consultant, mm-hmm. trainer, web developer, mm-hmm. digital marketer, mm-hmm. IT expert. You are the founder and CEO of ZigTech.
Yes.
ZigTech Corporation, a child from ZigTech organization mm-hmm. that has been running from 2009?
19. 19
or
9? ZTech Organization 2009, okay. ZTech Corporation 2019.
All right then. Thank you for the correction. Mm-hmm. Okay. The organization is to create opportunities for entrepreneurs in Africa. Mm-hmm. What motivates you to launch your company? You know, is there any story behind?
Okay. Simply what motivated me to run my company is, after high school, I never had the urge to work for somebody.
Wow.
I thought maybe working for somebody was a waste of time of my abilities, right? It's good to work because I think if you work in the right way, you build the skills that you need to run a business. So, but to me, I believe I had to start by creating other entrepreneurs. So I started out after my studies. I said, okay, I worked for a while. I worked for IRAD, Institute of Research for Agricultural Development. It's a government institute. But I didn't find myself after a year and some months. And I said, okay, it's good. Let me go in full time. So it's after the creation of ZTech that I said, okay, let me go full time into creating entrepreneurs. And what really brought me joy was to see that at the end of the day, somebody who had no skill, no money, could start a business, could rent his home, could fund for himself, and also could help other people. So that was the dream that really captured.
Okay, tell us about ZTech.
Okay, ZTech is an organization I founded in 2009. And the main reason for the organization was to build the capacity of young people to become entrepreneurs. So I saw the need of having young people who desired a change and also didn't know how to go about it. Young people had ideas, but didn't know how to become entrepreneurs and how to proceed and how to put in place structures to develop their businesses. So that's the idea of ZTech organization. And I didn't want to create another organization. I wanted to create a social enterprise, which simply means that it's an organization that is based on services. So it's the services that run the business, right? So we get income from developing websites, from teaching people about digital marketing. And the impact of it is having free training. So for example, we can go to a community and train young people on how to use Facebook for business, how to use YouTube for business, how you can be a professional digital marketer. So those are the things we develop with the tech organization. And it's been a fantastic journey so far.
How can I profit from ZTech technology or services?
Okay, so we have programs every month. So every month we have digital marketing trainings where you can apply to be a student and you go through the trainings. We also have so many other trainings. So simply you just go to the website or you go to the Facebook page and you give your request. So are you an entrepreneur? You have a business idea, but you don't know how to go about it, or you need skills in terms of technology. So when you send your request, it's more of a customized solution. So there are times we do general trainings for everybody. We do paid trainings and we do free training. So when you contact us, we'll be able to give you the right services that will fit your needs.
Okay. I also read somewhere you're a fund manager. Mm-hmm. What does it mean?
Okay, so a fund manager is simply someone that manages the money of other people.
Okay.
So we have people all over the world. You can be an individual who wants to invest. You're working and you want to keep a percentage of your income for investment. So a percentage of what comes to you, you want to invest it, but you don't know where to invest. So what you do is you bring the money to me and I will direct you on where to invest and get the best deals for you. So we have investors all over in the US, in South Africa, and they really want to invest in Cameroon and Africa, but they don't know where particularly to invest. Because we are on the ground, we know the entrepreneurs, we know their homes, we know their characteristics, we know everything about them. So they give us the money for us to invest in their place.
But and we how earn, do you find them?
You find them anywhere because we go to conferences, you have investment conferences, you have LinkedIn, you have lots of sites where you have angel investors. There are angel investors, which means they invest in very small companies, which means companies that do not have a growth strength. And that have maybe a low capital income. So they invest in those little companies and they invite us and say, okay, can you tell us the companies that are best to invest? So we recommend startups to them to invest. So what they simply do is there's an account where the money goes into. And now we as a fund manager, what I do is I direct the money where I see there will be return on investment. So the more they make money, the more I make money. So I earn a commission on every return on investment.
So who are your clients?
Okay, so my clients are basically the rich. My clients are the wealthy. My clients are also normal employees who are working in banks, who are working in state corporations, who are working in government. For example, we have a client who is investing 100,000 every month. So what he does is he keeps aside 100,000 francs every month and we invest the money. So we'll give him now account, he wants return on investment after 2 years. So we invested in a small business and after 2 years, he starts generating income and starts generating extra revenue for the person.
Okay, I really want to understand how it works. Mm-hmm. You know, how do you connect investors with growth companies?
Okay, so for example, growth companies, we look out there for companies that are doing well. So we search through reports, through bank reports, Ecofin reports. We have lots of reports, Africa Invest reports and lots of reports. And also we meet those startups and those companies in seminars, in summits, and also by referrals. So we have a list of companies that are doing very well because it's based on those companies that put their information out there. If your information is not out there, it's difficult for us to know. So those companies put their information out there. For example, STV wants to invest in Gabon and he puts it over the social media, we see that, okay, there's a growth pattern, there's a growth opportunity, and therefore we contact you to find out if there's any need for investment. So when we see that there's a need for investment, we find out the amount that you need, and in our database of investors, we can contact to say, okay, there's this company, STV, that wants to expand, is expanding, you understand, in other parts of Africa. This is an opportunity to invest because there's an opportunity for growth, because every investor wants to see an opportunity for growth. If your business cannot show growth, they cannot invest in your business. We've been working, as I said, with Zitech organization since 2009, and I've been meeting entrepreneurs all over Cameroon and all over the world and Africa. But we discovered that there was a disconnect. We had lots of entrepreneurs doing so great things, and also they didn't have the money to continue or to pursue that growth. So we created Zitech Corporation in 2019, this year in January, and we registered it in the US as a corporation. So basically what we do is, legally, we can receive investment from the US, because most of our investors have companies and firms in the US, because of the compliance issue. Mm-hmm. You know, with Africa, especially Cameroon, there's a lot of technicalities when it has to do with the law. Mm-hmm. But if you're based in the US, because of compliance, you tend to be trustworthy. And therefore, we can have investments and also link them now to Africa.
Okay. If I may ask, what makes you so credible?
Okay. What makes us so credible?
It's just to ensure the televiewers, people watching us, you know, okay, they may like to follow you, mm-hmm, and find out more, you know. As when you talk about digital stuff, you know, somebody somewhere in the world investing into your business, mm-hmm, people are curious, you know. It's not yet in our culture, mm-hmm, to just jump into,
it's true,
you know, grab those kind of opportunities.
Yeah, sure.
You know, I just want to reassure the televiewers. What makes you so credible?
What really makes us credible is our work we've been doing with Zitech organization. We've been operating Zitech organization since 2009 with no funds, and we are more of an impact-driven organization. So we have a base where we've been working for more than 10 years with no funds, which means that we're not soliciting money from international organizations. We're operating from within, which means from Cameroon. All the resources were coming from within Cameroon, even though we had help, investors coming in later on. But what really gives us our strength is impact. We are more tied to the social, which means we are not more of a capitalist firm that we just want to make profit, but our concern is simply the community. Are you solving a problem that is really helping the community? So that's our strength. That is our greatest strength, because when investors come, they don't just want to bring money, but they also want to bring impact. They also want to feel that, okay, their money is really changing lives. It's not just giving them an additional source of revenue, but also it's changing lives. So our key selling point is our impact story. What we've been able to do in Africa with little or no resources, because we started with nothing. I started from my house, and we built from my house up to where we are.
Okay, can you have an idea of your achievements?
Okay, so basically, I don't really love to talk much about that, but in 2016, we were nominated as the Social Enterprise of the Year by African Youth Award.
Okay.
And in 2017, we were invited by YALI. We also have little other achievements in Africa, because we are like the smallest investment fund, but that is organizing the African Business and Investment Summit. So we are barely 4 months old, but we are inviting investors from all over Africa and the world to come and invest in businesses and entrepreneurs in Africa. So that is a little bit of what we've been able to achieve so far.
Is there any challenge in your field? Yes. Doing this business, I don't know.
I would say there are lots of challenges. One thing is we can say young people are the future of tomorrow, but the young people need to take their destiny into their hands. So, for example, you have so many young people coming to you and say, oh, I need money for business, I need investors, but they are not willing to do the work that it takes to get those investors. Because it's not just about you being a CEO. You can have an idea, but you must not necessarily be the CEO of the company. You have so many businesses that the founders are not the CEOs, right? But in Cameroon or in Africa in general, you have lots of young people. So we are facing a lot of issues about young people. They don't want to develop their skills because having, for example, we have an investor who wants to invest $1 million into companies in small businesses in Africa. But how many small businesses can take $1 million? And that's what we find a difficulty because there's money in our hands. But where are the people to take the money? That's why we're organizing the African Business Investment Summit. I was talking with an investor 2 days ago, and he's willing to invest $5 million into an agri sector. But he wants to see growth. He wants to see professionalism. He wants to see so many things that these young people are not willing to give, right? We are just so passionate about entrepreneurship. But you need to create structures. Because somebody does not invest his money in the wind, right? He invests his money, his hard-earned cash, to really gain profit and also to invest and have a livelihood for his generation. So somebody will not give you, let's say, $100 million for you to joke about or for you to joke around. So I think the first issue we have is with entrepreneurs. The second issue we have is with government regulation, right? It's not really, the climate is not really favorable for investment. That is the truth. And also, if somebody invests in Cameroon and there's a problem, we know the issues we have with our judicial system. So that's why we took the conference to Rwanda. For example, in Rwanda, you have a day to create a business online. You are not going to any office. Same here in Cameroon, you create online, but you still need to go to an office to fulfill some paperwork. But in Rwanda, you can do everything online. You take a day to create a business. You don't pay anything to create a business. That's an incentive, right? Another thing for investors, for you to do business in Rwanda, for example, you need $80,000 a year to pay for your visa for you to be able to stay in Rwanda as a business person for 1 year. But in Cameroon, we have no fixed figure. So we have difficulties in terms of government regulation, and also the political and the socioeconomic climate is not really favorable for investment. Why? Because an investor will say, if I'm investing in Cameroon, what are the guarantees? What guarantee do I have that after 2, 3 months, 4 months, or a year, I'll still have my investment? We have to also take into consideration that investors invest in the long term. So which means they don't invest just for 1, 2, 3 years. They invest 5, 10, 15 years. So they want to see clarity in terms of governance. So a lot of those things are hindrances in terms of bringing the appropriate investment into.
What are your requirements?
Okay, so first of all, I would say is a business climate, right? Is a business climate, deregulate a lot of things. We don't need a lot of rules. Normally, you need rules to govern, but deregulate a lot of things. I think visa to Cameroon should be free. And that's why we chose Rwanda, because we are inviting more than 60 countries for the business summit. And you need, for example, let me give you a simple example. Traveling 15 countries in Africa, I'll tell you for a fact, that countries that have a visa-free policy have a high level of influx of capital coming in and business people. Okay. I take 45 minutes to cross immigration in Cameroon, but I take 3 minutes to cross the same immigration in Rwanda. Wow. So tell me, where will I go normally? I'll definitely choose Rwanda. So I think a visa-free policy will be good. Also, the taxation system, you know, normally, we have a declarative taxation system, but no one is held into account if he overtaxes an entrepreneur. So most entrepreneurs shun away from big businesses because they are afraid of taxes, because there's no clarity in terms of it. So I think if the government can put up a structure in which you have clarity to say, okay, if you're making this amount, you know, and if there's a complaint, you can complain and the person is sanctioned. I think that will go a long way in improving the business climate. Cameroon. Okay.
To talk about sexual health before it's too late. Sylvie Uriwa, étudiante en médecine, et son jeune frère jumeau Sylvain Muzungu ont mis sur pied une application rwandaise d'éducation des jeunes à la sexualité appelée Tanti. Venue d'une observation faite, les jeunes filles au Rwanda devenaient mères de manière précoce, n'ayant jamais reçu une éducation sexuelle et obligées d'arrêter leurs études. La plateforme panafricaine d'e-commerce Jumia a officiellement annoncé son entrée à la Bourse de New York, la plus grande salle des marchés du monde. La cérémonie a eu lieu au Wall Street, un moment historique pour l'entreprise, le résultat d'un travail d'équipe. D'après un article publié par The Guardian, Jumia est actuellement actif au Nigeria et dans 13 pays africains, avec plus de 81 000 vendeurs actifs effectuant des transactions en ligne avec des millions de consommateurs. En Guinée, Fadima Diawara, la fondatrice de Kumfabo, une marque de smartphone low-cost 100% africain. Kumfabo, composé d'applications préinstallées et purement africaines, est censé répondre à des besoins locaux avec des applications intégrées de géolocalisation, de centres de santé, hôpitaux, pharmacies et bien d'autres. La marque devrait être lancée au courant de cette année et proposera à des consommateurs des smartphones et des smartwatches à prix abordable, d'après un article publié le 16 avril dernier par African Shaper. L'Afrique abrite la majorité des entrepreneurs du monde, d'après un article publié le mois dernier par Africa Feed. L'Afrique subsaharienne a le taux d'entrepreneuriat le plus élevé au monde, avec environ 42% de la main-d'œuvre non agricole, classée en tant qu'indépendant ou employeur. Un nouveau rapport de la Banque mondiale indique que 76% des Africains considèrent l'entrepreneuriat comme un bon choix de carrière. Dear fellow viewers, welcome back. We have so many talents across Africa.
We have so many talents in Africa, and I think those talents just need to be showcased. And that's why we need to thank Belief, STV, and the other TV stations that are doing a great job to highlight and to showcase these talents. You meet a lot of young people doing. I met a young man in Ghana, that's in February, and he's making over $1 million in terms of revenue. So there are lots of talents in Africa, and we really need to celebrate them.
Okay. Any difficult time you face during your career,
yes,
you may like to share?
I had so many difficult moments. I would say starting my business was really, really difficult when I had to move from my house now to an office. I had a difficulty of, you know, Cameroon. In Cameroon, we love to see before we believe. And that's one thing that is also difficult for young entrepreneurs, because you just think giving up, like people don't really believe in what you're doing, and they want to see the results before they get to believe, before people say, okay, no, this person is really serious. So that's the first challenge I really had in my career. The next challenge is creating Zitech Corporation. You meet lots of business people with money, but they don't believe in Africa because of poor leadership. So how do we explain that there's an opportunity in Africa, but because of poor governance, you can still have your money after 20, 30 years? I think that's been really challenging for me to really convince people also.
More and more companies are trying to innovate and embrace new technology. You are a web developer, an IT expert. Is it possible for anyone to study web development?
It's very possible because it depends on you. If you believe you can do it, you can do it.
So you don't need to
need any technical skills. Everything is online because firstly I am self-taught before going for extra training. And we also have trainings where we have a week, within a week you can develop a website. So with those trainings, and I've seen young girls who had no skill in IT, in programming, in building websites or graphic, but after a week of training, because they put their mind to it, because of hard work, they can develop websites.
You are organizing the first edition of Africa Business and Investment Summit.
Yeah.
That will take place in Kigali, mm-hmm. Rwanda, from the 27th to 29th May.
Mm-hmm.
What is your objective?
The objective of the investment summit, first of all, is to bring entrepreneurs together to look into their businesses. Because entrepreneurs all over Africa, because our focus is Africa.
Okay.
We believe Africa is the next big thing to happen. It's already the only thing that has to happen in the world, to the world. So we're bringing entrepreneurs together and candidly look at our businesses. Ask ourselves, what is holding us back? You know, most times we have entrepreneurs who we just compare ourselves with those in the community to say, okay, how many entrepreneurs can make 50 million every year? You have very few of these small businesses. How many can make 500 million, 600 million? But if you go to South Africa, you go to the US, you see entrepreneurs making over 5, 20, 40 billion every year. And you ask yourself, okay, what is the problem? So our focus is investment, bringing investment to Africa, showing other entrepreneurs that it's possible, looking detailedly at our businesses and asking ourselves, what are the things that are not working? Also bringing the entrepreneurs in front of the investors.
Okay.
You understand? So the investors now will tell them, okay, this is what we are looking for. This is what we want to invest in. Can you walk on this path? Can you walk after 2 years, you come back to me? Or can you walk after 6 months, come back to me? So our outcome is that we want businesses to have investments at the end of the conference. We also want to see a growth in terms of employment. So how many of those companies will employ more people after a year? How many of those companies will increase in terms of revenue? And how many of those companies will increase in terms of technology and adoption?
A last word to those young people who like to create a business.
It's easy to create a business. Normally, we know it's challenging. We live in a very challenging environment. But those challenges should be an opportunity for you to outstretch yourself. Don't ask yourself what your country can do for you. Ask yourself, what can you do for your next, for your neighbor? What can you do for your community? Think about solutions that will really impact the lives of people. Don't get into business because you don't have a job. Get into business because you're passionate about Africa. Get into business because you're passionate about creating the Africa we want to see, creating jobs for the jobless, creating those opportunities, and also impacting your community. You know, money is a tool. And if you know money is a tool, you know the right business to get into. So I would say, don't be discouraged, no matter the challenges, no matter the hurdles on the way, be determined. And you know, if you believe, it's possible. If you don't believe, it's possible. So everything depends on you. When everybody sees that you believe, then people will rally behind you. But if they see that you don't believe, they will not believe in what you're doing. So the thing I would say is believe in yourself and believe in what you're doing.
Believe in yourself.
Yeah.
Okay, what about those who want to set up a business and they don't actually have enough funds?
Okay, so
what is your advice?
Those who really want to set up a business and they don't have enough funds, I would say, just email us info@zitechcorporation.com or go to zitechcorporation.com, the website, and you have our contact. We have lots of incentives, even in Cameroon, where you have we do a bit of crowdfunding, which means we go in the community of entrepreneurs. We have a network called Entrepreneurs Initiative. So we have entrepreneurs who are keeping money aside every month, every year, to invest in productive businesses. So there are little monies aside that you can take. There are local competitions in Africa, in Cameroon. We've talked of Tony Elumelu. We have so many competitions that young people can get into. And what we believe is those competitions are not just there for you to have money, but they also help to build your business. So when you contact us, we'll help you to locate what appropriate finance is good for you. Because when you're starting, it's not good to have so much money to start. Because when you have so much money to start, you won't be able to know every part of your business. Just take, for example, will you just leave STV right now and they give you a supermarket of 15,000 employees? I bet you will not know what to do. But if they start you up with a supermarket or a store of 2 persons, it goes to 3 persons, 4 persons, 10 persons, 20, 40, 50, 100. You know quite well what happens in an ecosystem of 10 employees. So if you have 15,000, you know exactly what to do, and you know exactly how your business functions, and you know when your business is failing, you know what to attack, and you know where to go. So money, I would say, is important, but is not the most important thing in business. In business, you need ideas. In business, you need the strength, the confidence. You need the fortitude, you need the foresight, the vision. The vision is very important. When you have all of that, the other things will come.
Mr. Paul Mboa, thank you so much for your time. You know, we spend a wonderful time together. Mm-hmm. You know, all the best.
Thank you very much, and it's a pleasure being here, and I enjoyed myself.
Chers téléspectateurs, merci pour votre fidélité. On se retrouve très prochainement pour une autre édition Believe in Africa. Ciao, ciao.